see Christmas through each verse of Scripture that tells us what happened so long ago.
But what if we saw it through the eyes of a different lens, through the eyes of those who had been promised that a Messiah would appear? Those who had spent a lifetime watching and waiting and longing for that promise to be fulfilled.
God, our Maker, great Creator, our Sustainer, show us your favor. We're a nation with frustrations, expectations, needing a Savior now. We cry out.
Every prophecy made about the Savior's coming was about to converge in a little town not far from Jerusalem.
God would use a virgin girl and a poor carpenter, a Roman ruler and a Bethlehem innkeeper, some ordinary shepherds and a host of angels.
And God would send his only begotten son to a world that desperately needed him.
So this is how it was, a silent night like any other. When heaven sent the one that we would call our Savior, and redemption began in a stable in Bethlehem.
Everyone.
is truly God, wrapped up in a tattered blanket. Hope was finally here, sleeping while the world awakened, and redemption began with a baby in Bethlehem. All of the angels lifted up their voices and filled the night with hallelujahs. God is with us now. Everyone come and join the heavenly chorus. Our Savior King is here before us. Oh, to
says Mary brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling cloths and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn.
Now we have imagined that innkeeper in countless ways, from cold and clueless to concerned. Whoever he was, whatever he did or said, Jesus was born just the way God had intended all along.
They had come from afar. They had searched all over town. There was no room to be found. The night was here. They had no place to stay. The inn was full, and yet I couldn't turn them away. It wasn't much, I told them so. A humble bed in from the cold. For I'm just a simple man, please understand. I have no wealth to give. It was just a cattle stall, a bed of straw, where no child should have to live. But he needed shelter, any place to lay his head. So I gave the babe from heaven. A humble babe. He had come from afar, leaving golden streets behind, but he didn't seem to mind. And he was here, I didn't know it then. Who would ever think this tiny baby could be him? It wasn't much, no kingly throne, a humble bed in from the cold. For I'm just a simple man, please understand, I have no wealth to give. It was just a cattle stall, a bed of straw, where no child should have to live. But he needed shelter, any place to lay his head. So I gave the babe from heaven. A humble bed. It was so very unexpected to meet a king this way. But in the sky that night, a star shone bright above the baby sleeping on the hay. For I'm just a simple man, please understand, I have no wealth to give. It was just a cattle stall, a bed of straw, where no child should have to live. But he needed shelter, any place to lay his head. So I gave the babe from heaven. A humble bed.
They were ordinary men doing their ordinary jobs out on the Bethlehem hills that night.
But one moment of blinding light from above, a messenger from heaven, a sky set ablaze with glory, one moment would change their lives forever.
Glorious Jesus.
light pierced the darkness of that holy night, and far from Bethlehem there were men who took notice.
To these wealthy scholars, the star announced the birth of a ruler, a leader, perhaps a king. It declared the coming of someone who would change the world.
It's what the star had always said. Jesus had come and nothing would be the same.
Said the night wind to the little lamb. Do you see what I see? Way up in the sky, little lamb. Do you see what I see? A star, dancing in the night with a tail as big as a kite. With a tail as big as a kite. Said the little lamb to the shepherd boy, do you hear what I hear? Ringing through the sky, shepherd boy, do you hear what I hear? Oh, a song, high above the trees, with a voice as big as the sea. With a voice as big as the sea.
Listen. Oh, listen. Said the shepherd boy to the mighty king, do you know what I know? In your palace, warm, mighty king, do you know what I know? Said the king to the people everywhere, listen to what I say. Pray for peace, people of fear. Listen to what I say. Oh, a child, sleeping in the night, he will bring us goodness and light. He will bring us goodness and light. Oh, yeah. Listen. Do you hear what I hear? Do you see what I see? Do you know what I know? Pray for peace, people everywhere. Listen. Do you hear what I hear? Do you see what I see? Do you know what I know? Pray for peace, people everywhere. Oh, a child, sleeping in the night, he will bring us goodness and light. He will bring us goodness and light. Do you know what I know?
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 Before Jesus was born, God's word says the people walked in darkness, but then he came And Scripture says he was the light of the world. Yet in many ways, we still live in a world shrouded in night.
Those who don't know Jesus cry out for hope and search for peace. Those of us who do know him and who follow him long for the day when his peace will reign, the day when he will come again.
I heard the bells on Christmas Day, their old familiar carols play, and mild and sweet their songs repeat, of peace on earth, goodwill to men. And the bells are ringing,
peace on earth,
like a choir they're singing. In my heart I hear them, peace on earth, goodwill to men. In despair I bow my head, there is no peace on earth, I said. For hate is strong and mocks the song, a peace on earth, goodwill to men. The bells are ringing, like a choir they're singing. Does anybody hear them? Peace on earth, goodwill to man. Then rang the bells more loud and deep. God is not dead, nor does he sleep. The wrong shall fail, the right prevail, with peace on earth, goodwill to men. And ringing, singing on its way, the world revolved from night to day. A voice, a chime, a chant sublime, with peace on earth, goodwill to men. And the bells, they're ringing, like a choir singing. With our hearts we'll hear them, peace on earth, goodwill to men. Do you hear the bells, they're ringing, like an angel singing? Open up your hearts and hear them, peace on earth, goodwill to man, peace on earth, peace on earth, peace on earth, goodwill to men.
Luke 2:17-19 says, After seeing him, the shepherds told everyone what had happened and what the angel had said to them about this child. All who heard the shepherd's story were astonished, but Mary kept all these things in her heart and thought about them often.
Just like the shepherds, we can't keep quiet about what happened in Bethlehem so long ago. We have to tell others that God sees us and he loves us. He loves us so much that he was willing to give his only son, Jesus, to save us.
At the same time, like Mary, we keep all these things in our hearts and ponder how amazing it is that God sees us and he loves us. He loves us so much that he was willing to give his only son, Jesus, to save us.
The bells of Christmas are ringing out the good news. Unto you is born this day a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. This is the reason we are filled with joy and hope.
So let's share the message with anyone who will listen. And let's live in a way that says his love makes all the difference.
The Lord has come.
Our King is born. It's Christmas.
Christmas.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing.
Sing a new song, open up your heart, let the world know that the music starts. Come on, sing out joy to the world. Everybody come from all around, lift up your voice and make a joyful sound. Come on, sing out joy to the world.
He rules the world with truth and grace, and makes the nations prove the glories of his righteousness, and wonders of his love, and wonders of his love.
Sing a new song, open up your heart, let the world know that the music starts. Come on, sing out joy to the world. Everybody come from all around, lift up your voice and make a joyful sound. Come on, sing loud joy to the world.
Joy, joy, joy.
Okay, let's do some recognition here. First of all, welcome everyone. We're glad you're here. And on behalf of the community choir in Lawrenceville Baptist Church, we hope you have enjoyed the service so far. We've got some refreshments afterwards. We hope everyone can stay for that. But first of all, let's recognize folks. Kathy should be first. This is our director, put all this together. Let's give her a hand. Okay, now while we got everybody up here, your helper, English, not Leah Vice, used to be in English. I'm about 3 years behind. Leah directed, was co-director up here with you, so thank you, Leah. Take that microphone, because I'm going to botch all this. Tell us who did what. Their soloist was Shane Smoot. Shane? Ray? Allison Carrick, right here. Carrie Jo Carrick and Kim Moore. Who? Oh, yeah. Melanie Crouch, raise your hand. Alyssa Williams. Gabriella DeFazio. Shelby and Olivia. Okay. Abby and Gabrielle. Okay, that's why I wanted you to do this.
Our narrators,
Marsha and Matt. Yeah.
Our other dancer went back there.
Oh, come up here so we can clap for you. What's the matter with you? Yeah, this was our lead dancer, wasn't it? Hiding in the back. Yeah, good job. She also and her sister ran the soundboard sometimes during practices. John back there videotaped it tonight and ran the sound during some practices. What else do we have? Oh, our backdrop. Yeah, our backdrop is put together by Kevin and Thelma Harris. Isn't this great?
Yes, it is.
There are people who can design and people who can build, and they just do it all. They just come up with a whole concept and put it together, and they do a great job. Anything else? Have I missed anything else? That's it? Okay, Merry Christmas. Would you guys like to go sit down, or... Okay, go sit down. Go sit down. Sit down where you are, and some of these need to see. Kathy just about made a memory for us, didn't she? Okay, we're going to take up a love offering, and every penny of this goes to the community choir. The money's all kept separate. We'll use this money to buy music for the next cantata. So I'd like to get a couple of folks to help us. Let's see. Barry, could you and Jordan help us take up the money? Plates are right over here. And what page are we on?
91.
91 in your hymnals. Let's sing Silent Night while we took up this offering tonight. Sing it together. You want to lead it?
Me and bronchitis. I need louder music. Tell everybody.
Sing out, guys.
Silent night. Holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round yon virgin mother and child, holy infant.
I thought you meant me. You're talking about the Lord, aren't you? That's meaningful. Please stay for a time of refreshment and fellowship. We've got to just go this way, and hope everybody can stay for that. I'm kind of dragging a little bit because I think they wanted a moment or two to get all the food out. So when we have a closing prayer, don't be in a big hurry to get over there. Just visit a while, hug some people, and then give them time to get stuff together. Also, we probably should talk about who's here. Starting back here with Gary, that's White Oak, and there's Preston, and Sharpsburg, and who else? Slate Valley?
Owensville Christian,
United Methodist. Who else? In the children's group, what churches?
Morse Ferry.
You can tell he just moved here. Yeah. There's no Moores Valley. Any of you from different churches? And Owensville Baptist. We had a few. Mount Sterling, First Baptist. Heritage Christian? Okay. Yeah. So really it is Salt Lake Christian. That's right. So it really is a community choir. So we invite all of you to be a part of it. We were looking this morning. The Easter falls April 16th. So it's a little later this year. Last year it was really close, and we felt like we'd just finished and rolled right into it. So this year we can take 2 weeks off before we start. So, but hope if you'd like to be a part of it, please join. Would you stand together? Let's have closing prayer. And as we pray, we also want to bless the food that we're going to share. Brother Dennis Carman, would you lead us in prayer and bless the food for us? Thank you for being here tonight, and God bless you.
God, for our faithfulness until he comes, that we would occupy until he returns until that, so that we would give witness to him, to those who do not know him. Thank you for this presentation tonight, for each life involved in it. Thank you for this church and the church of Jesus Christ throughout the world. We thank you, Lord, for the opportunity for fellowship. We pray you'll bless the food that we partake of and the fellowship that we will enjoy because of you here tonight. In Jesus' name I pray.